So why aren't these bloody things so flexible? Well, because they're so bloody complex. I'd say that we are moving into new territory. The rates of change are higher than we've ever seen, even in the very fast periods of change as we came out of ice ages or went into ice ages.
Now, there is no doubt that climate is changing, absolutely no doubt, because we're getting every year extremely hot weather. Now, in the last sort of something like 13 years, we've had 10 of the hottest years on record. That's more than a coincidence.
So if every time we have a bleaching event, we only lose 2 or 3 or 5% of the reefs, it only takes 20 bleaching events and you start to have some really serious consequences for the Great Barrier Reef.
Climate change debate, there's one big thing that we don't know, and that is the capacity of corals to adapt. Can they adapt to warmer seawater temperatures?
We are trying to do the experiments to actually prove that certain sozzatelli give you a better tolerance to high temperature.
All right, so this problem of adaptation, and this has been a source of lots of wishful thinking. Maybe zooxanthellae can be swapped out of corals and you get a new set and you can then adapt to the new circumstances. Well, if that's true, then I think we should really, you know, have some nice data for that, because that's such an important loophole to the problem that we're facing.
Last summer, a curious thing happened. We had a coral bleaching event. It stressed most of the corals at Magnetic Island, including the ones that we had transplanted from cooler areas there. Of all the corals that we had there, most of them died, but two corals survived. The ones that survived were bleached as white as my shirt, but when they recovered with a different clade of zooxanthellae than what they first started. And we now see tantalising evidence that this different clade of zooxanthellae also has changed the thermal tolerance limits of these corals. So it is linking both the change in zooxanthellae with a change in thermal tolerance, and that'll be the first time that that's been shown.
Maggie, 3.
I guess the coral has now become a new functional unit. It has a new job, I guess, a new job description, and that means it can live in a warmer area. How wonderful is that?
Considerable part of the heat tolerance is genetic, that will tell us that it's actually maybe quite feasible to selectively breed more thermotolerant corals. So the research will sort of lay the basis for selective breeding programs of corals, which is then, you know, maybe 3-4 years down the track, that's the next phase we want to move into.
There is nothing to say that we can't do that with corals, that we couldn't bring them into the laboratory, pick individuals which have naturally better thermal tolerance, breed them and reseed damaged reefs with these more thermally tolerant individuals.
I think this sort of science is fascinating, absolutely fascinating. you know, it's something we should be exploring and, you know, doing as much research as possible. It's just we have to make sure that we are critically examining where it fits into the big scheme of things.
I'm very hopeful, yes.
And having little discoveries like this, because this really turns the world upside down, doesn't it?